Zooming in and out sounds boring, right? But stick with me, I dare you. Because you'll probably learn at least one trick that will improve how you use After Effects every single time. Let's be honest, zooming and navigating the comp viewer is something we all constantly do, and for most of us, it's a muscle memory. But Adobe recently introduced a new smooth zoom feature, and it brings buttery precise magnification to the composition, layer, and footage panels. So let's zoom in, pun very much intended, and explore everything this feature can do for us. So first, let's visit the preferences. Under previews, over there we can change the magnification type. Let's start with legacy. And the behavior, I'm going to set it to centered to demonstrate how things used to behave in previous versions. So to zoom in and out, you can use, of course, command or control with the plus or minus key. Or my preferred way is to use the comma and period keys. These will jump between preset percentage values that you can also choose manually from the magnification pop-up. Since we're set to centered, the zoom happens from the center of the viewer. Want to see a pixel for pixel preview? Hit the forward slash key, and on high DPI screens, it might say 200%, but it's still showing 1 for 1 pixels. Pinching a trackpad, if you have one, will do the same thing and jump between those values. And if you need to fit the viewer to the current frame size, press Option or Alt and the forward slash. Now, if you want to zoom into wherever your mouse is, hold the Option key and scroll up or down. Okay, now let's go back to Preferences. You can do it by pressing Command, Option and semicolon. Go to the previews and change the behavior to follow cursor. This means that your zoom will now target wherever your mouse pointer is, which is very handy. No keyboard shortcut needed here, just pinch or scroll, or if you're using a mouse, you can just scroll up and down. Coming back to the previous settings, I'll change the type to smooth, leaving the other options as is. So the behavior will follow the cursor and the trackpad scrolling will be set to zooms. And here's where things get, well, smooth. Pinch on your trackpad or scroll with your mouse and enjoy the silky smooth zoom. Also try to highlight this value and use the up and down arrow keys to change it in 1% increments. If you add shift to the mix, it will jump in tens. You can even do basic math here, like any hot text in After Effects. So I'm going to type asterisk 1.5 after the number to multiply the zoom by this value. Of course, the zoom tool still works the same. I'll press Z to activate it, and I'll click to zoom in, or option click to zoom out. If I'll click and drag, it will use the smooth zoom, so I can drag up or down. If you prefer the old marquee style zoom, just switch the magnification type back to legacy. And now you can just marquee around an area and it will zoom to this area. I rarely use this behavior, so I don't think I'm going to miss this option, but it's here if you need it. Okay, let's switch back to smooth zoom, but this time I'll set the trackpad scrolling to pans. I'll return to the selection tool to demonstrate this and use 2 fingers on the trackpad to pan around the viewer. I think for most laptop users, this will be the most natural and logical way to work. You can still pinch to zoom in and out, but you can also navigate around the comp, which is great if you work with 3D layers and activate the extended viewer option to see all the content outside the comp dimensions. However, this can be a bit annoying if you're using a mouse, since scrolling the wheel will scroll the viewer up and down. Hold shift, by the way, for left and right. But if you like me and you're used to the old behavior of zooming in and out, you might want to change it back to zooms. And now it works like I'm expecting it to. Now here's a pro tip. Regardless of the behavior you set in the previous preferences, you can reverse it by holding the Option or Alt key. So even if I set it to follow cursor, when I'll press and hold the Option key and scroll up or down, it will do it from the center of the viewer. Again, the center of the viewer window, not the center of the composition. Also, when you hold Option and have some 3D layers in the composition, you might see the universal camera icon. Don't panic, that's just After Effects being helpful-ish. All right, so a few quirks you should know about. Smooth zoom lets you zoom in further than before, but some values may be grayed out. That's due to the 30K pixel buffer limit inside After Effects. Adobe knows, and they are working on it. Also, smooth zoom currently doesn't work while the comp is playing. You can use the comma and period key instead, and they still work, but snap to those set levels. All in all, Adobe clearly put a lot of care and love into this feature. It feels natural, intuitive, and best of all, optional. If you don't like it, you can always revert to the old way. That said, I'm curious. Are you using Smooth Zoom? If not, why? Drop a comment. It might reach someone at Adobe. Until then, I'm zooming out. Thanks so much for watching. And if you made it this far, leave a magnification emoji in the comments below so I know you are a real person. Bye.